This is Wretched Radio with Todd Friel.
Indeed. Another one busts the dust. Hey. This is Wretched Radio. Another famous Christian bites the dust. Oh, so unnecessary. Don't know if you heard the news story. Whether you follow the Canadian Christian rock band Hawk Nelson or not, Fox News picked up on it, so it must have some oomph behind it. A young man saying, "I no longer believe in God," giving scant information as to why, but I read the details that at least were provided publicly, and it just makes me because he is asking questions and not receiving answers. A young man who grew up in a Christian home, I don't know what denomination or stripe, nevertheless, he was asking some basic questions, or maybe at the time he wasn't, but he was never being given big truths and big Christian defenses as to why the veracities of the Christian faith are veracities, why they're true. And so it is, we see a young man who sang his Christian songs, who trolloped around in Christian circles, now saying, "You know what, I don't believe in God." The name of the band again is Hawk Nelson. Joey, I don't know how big they were, but they're big enough to get on Fox News.
Yeah, they
and to
were
make
kind
all the
of
Christian
a
Post
medium
and
big.
All the different yeah. outlets here, stating, "After growing up in a Christian home, being a pastor's kid, playing and singing in a Christian band, and having the word Christian in front of most of the things in my life, I'm finding that I no longer believe in God. That's a drag. I'm stunned," he writes, "by the number of people in visible positions within Christian circles that feel the same way as I do." What? "Like me, they fear losing everything if they open up about it." Well, yeah, you should, because if you're not a Christian, you shouldn't be in the biz, man. Then you are just using God to peddle him for merchandise and to make a living. So it's not about losing everything. It is no longer ascribing to those Christian truths. You don't believe them anymore. You can't be a spokesperson for them. That's pretty simple. A thought. He recalled some uncomfortable church moments, such as praying in public and emotional cries for the Holy Spirit at youth events. Then he goes on to give his reasons why he's no longer a Christian. Mom and Dad, pay attention. If you have not addressed these issues with your kid, you could have yourself another Hawk Nelson, or whatever the young man's name is. Make sure, youth pastor, you are not simply playing with, no, don't play with whipped cream anyway. No whipped cream, no peanut butter business, no gross out games. We need zero of, none of it. None of it. We don't need any. Well, the kids, man, they got to have some fun. Sure they do. The world offers fun. The church should be offering truth and a foundation. You don't understand, man. They won't come if they don't have fun. Oh, I'm trying to find a verse in the Bible that says the church's job is to amuse and entertain the kids. I can't find that, but I sure can find a lot of verses that teach us that it is our responsibility to pass along the truths that have been given to us, that have been passed to us by people who bled and died, not the least of whom was our Savior. That's our job, not whoop-de-doo. The list of things that didn't make sense to him kept growing throughout the years. He noted, quote, Eric, can you guess what the biggie is?
Why
if God
does
is
good,
all yeah. loving and all powerful, why is there evil in the world? Can he not do anything about it? Does he choose not to? He never heard the answer to this. If not, I would prefer he say, "I do not accept the Christian explanation for this." I'd prefer that, but that's not the way it was presented. It's like, well, the Christian, but nobody's ever been able to sort out that conundrum for me. Are you kidding? This has been sorted out since the beginning. We've got this figured out. Now, he may not like it. That's a different issue. Not hearing it? Church, this is... Sorry, but this is why we're doing Road Trip to Truth. I am telling you this series that we have created, it is We're right now we're in polishing stage on this 13-episode TV show, Road Trip to Truth, the first season. It's all being polished, putting together a study guide for youth group because of kids like this. Also, later, we're putting together a homeschool curriculum. That's going to be a ways out because it's far more detailed. But the youth group curriculum, it hits this question right on the nose. Why is there evil in the world? Because God ordained it. What? Is he not loving? Clearly he's loving because the Bible says so. And we need to figure out how to harmonize it because it's perfectly clear in God's mind. He ordained evil because out of that, something greater than we could ever imagine is going to happen. And that greater thing is we are going to know God better and deeper than we could if evil did not exist. Now, people can reject that and go, I don't like that answer. That's fine. I get that. When Christians struggle with that, I even understand that to a degree. How do you remedy that? It's a different, it's filtering life through a different system. Instead of the how does this work for me system, what does this say about God is the system? If God created a universe, and it's a pretty big place, fairly complex, and he put two people here to represent us, knowing that we would sin, knowing that there would be evil, catastrophe, war, all kinds of wicked behavior, because out of that, his glory would shine greater because of the redemptive work of his son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who became sin that we might become the righteousness of God, then instead of focusing on, well, I don't know that I like that, I should be asking, whoa, what is it that I am to learn about God? If he is that amazing, that great, that profound, that good, that delightful, and this is the means that he has chosen to demonstrate that so that I can enjoy it, I want in. That should be my perspective change. Now, well, I don't think this is right. I don't think that I would have done it this way. That's because we can't grasp God and his goodness and his bigness and his vastness. And why that he has done this, because we are going to enjoy him more than Adam and Eve ever could. That is a staggering thought. They walked with him in the cool of the eve, enjoying God, not as much as you and I are in the new garden. Not nearly as much, because we will have seen, whoa, he saves sinners? He doesn't save good people, God saves bad people? Because he's that good? Whoa. And you're going to bask in that and swim in the depths of that knowledge for all of eternity and never get to the bottom of its goodness. I need to adjust my perspective, and our kids need to understand this. And so this isn't just a, okay, so here's the glib answer why there's evil in the world. Now let's move on and get back to the squirt guns. No, now we need to show how good God is and how amazing grace is and what Jesus did for us on the cross. And to start to begin, if that's what God wants us to know about him and enjoy about him, I want to get on that now. I don't want to wait for heaven. I want to start experiencing that life abundant now. Back to the Hawk Nelson singer denying that God exists anymore in his mind. He struggled with, quote, why does God say not to kill, but then instruct Israel to turn around and kill men and women and children to take the promised land? Could that be any simpler? And yet, he's using this as his excuse to deny the existence of God? That's staggering to me. Again, I'd prefer he say, you know, I don't like it. I don't like that God says this and then does that. I don't like it. Or I don't grasp it. But that's not the way that this is being presented. He didn't know the answer. And I suspect he was never offered one. At least not consistently and persistently. How's about there's a difference between killing and murder? How's about everybody who dies, in a sense, God kills because he takes their life? How's about that perspective? And God is right in doing so, because God doesn't owe any of us a single breath, let alone our next breath. God can kill anybody that he wants to. Murder, verboten. If it is justifiable because it's been commanded by God, God can use human beings to execute other people. But that's not murder. That's killing. That's the difference. The command is thou shalt not murder, not thou shalt not kill. We can kill animals to eat them, too. We're not murdering animals. We're killing them to eat them because they're tasty. Quote, here's another struggle. Get ready for this one. The artist came to the conclusion the Bible can't be trusted, because in the end, he felt it was human, flawed, and imperfect. So he never was taught the veracity of the Bible in that textual criticism tells us this book is exactly accurate. It's not a game of telephone. Another subject we hit in Road Trip to Truth. that it was not passed down orally. It's a written transmission, thousands of manuscripts. But here's the biggie. Get ready for this. Kid, pastor's kid. This is why he doesn't believe in God. Here it is. Drum roll, please. Why does Jesus have to die for our sins?
There we are.
That's more killing again. Are you kidding me? That this young man doesn't know the answer to that question? Penal substitutionary atonement? The lamb sacrifices pointing to the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world? He was singing Christian songs, growing up in a Christian home, and never understood the basics. Oh, youth pastor, your responsibility? Get on it. And don't listen to the voices that tell you, we got to entertain a man. Like, this kid has lived his life being entertained and entertaining, but he doesn't know the truth. And when he dies in his sins, if he hasn't repented and trusted Jesus, he's going to hell. And so will a lot of the kids in your youth group. Get on it, sir. Mom and Dad, we too. Until tomorrow, go serve your king.
Hey,
hey, Todd.
Sweetie.
Stick around the block a few times?
Who's a good girl? You're not, because nobody does good. No, not one. Romans 5 says we're born in sin and iniquity, and our hearts are deceitful and wicked. You know that if you'd use the law, which brings about the knowledge of sin.